Forecast the future, how to build a reference class. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about how we can build a reference class for a project or for small phases on a project and why it matters, how we can actually research the data and how that then integrates with the team. So if you're into that, stay with us. Okay, so this is a jam, and I want to shout out Neftali and Alex with our Lean Tech team because they put this together with one of our clients. But we're here in the field and wanted to show you how to put together a reference class. So we're in the office right now showing the information on a mirror board. And if you ever want additional information, you can just reach out to us in the comments below or contact me through my contact information. But here's the point. A reference class is a class of information for multiple projects that gathers data, typically the overall budget and schedule, or the budget overruns and the schedule overrun, so that we can see historically how long things take and how long things cost. The reason we want to do this is because we always, as human beings, think, oh, it'll go fine, but it never goes fine. So we need to get a reference class with as many examples as we can to really figure out how long these things will take and cost. So Alex and Neftali on this job literally did this with a transition. It was an owner's move-in into a new facility so that a renovation could be done in the existing facility. And so the owner wanted to narrow that time for the GCs and the GRs, obviously to save costs for the owner and for themselves. Absolutely great client, doing a fantastic job on schedule, but they needed to know how long that would take. So what the team here did, they literally referenced as many examples of owner move-ins or transfers as they possibly could. So if we look into one of these from the internet research, you can see that they identified the building, they understood exactly what that represented from a program type, what the mobilization process looked like, any roadblocks or constraints, and then the exact duration that they were experiencing at the bottom of this. So the duration on each one of these. And they were able to aggregate that and average that. So as we zoom out, what we'll see is that we, in this case, were able to find 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, about 7 to 10 of these reference class examples. Now we want 50, but we're getting as many as we possibly can. Now, this is what the outcome of it was. What we want to do is then pull that into a production plan. So Alex, let's go ahead and zoom over here, and I want to see your production plan. So you can see this legend, and then the timeline on the top, and then the swim lanes and the actual production plan in a tactic format. Absolutely brilliant stuff. So this right here is not a guess. This is not just us wishfully thinking. This is not just a request. This is not, you know, us just typing things into the computer. The durations, the sequence, were based off of a reference class. And so this was the document, and this is in Miro, but obviously this was printed out. The production plan with the legend, and actually the method, the suggested method of the move-in, was all mapped out. So once they saw all of this information, they reviewed this information, integrated it with the owner and the trade partners, and were able to refine this to where they have a solid plan. And so here's what we have after this. We have our legend, we have our maps, we have our production plan. Not a guess. Based off of a reference class, we understand exactly how long it's going to take in the right sequence from historical information, and we have deliverables that can be followed for this owner transfer, for this owner move-in. So this is absolutely fantastic. Here's my point. When you do something that's unknown, when you have a new project, don't just go from a guess. Get a reference class, research historical information, find out how long things typically take, find out how long things typically cost, then integrate that with your owner and your trade partners, and you will have a sure end date and a solid plan. And in the description below, what we will do is we will give you a beautifully formatted Canva graphic for this. And if you ever need help, reach out to us. But I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.